Hey, it's Kurt at the Top Corner Hockey Studio. Thanks for watching. We all know that drafting NHL players is a gamble most of the time. Once in a while, there's a surefire guy. Mario Lemieux, Sidney Crosby, Connor McDavid. These guys we know are going to be superstar NHL players as long as they stay healthy. And even Mario Lemieux, who wasn't healthy a lot of the time, still is one of the greatest hockey players in NHL history. Other times you get pleasant surprises. Guys that are drafted later on become great NHL players. What I'm going to do in this video is I'm going to look at the top three scorers for each draft class starting in 2000. I'll rank them 3, 2, 1 to tell you who are the highest scorers from each draft and their draft position. You can get an idea on which players were drafted where and how well they did in their careers. Some of them are done. Most of them, though, are still playing. We'll go all the way up to 2017. I found it really interesting to see which players were the highest scoring. Often, it is not the guy who's drafted first overall. But we'll find out in this video the highest scoring players per draft class from 2000 to 2017. Justin Williams was drafted 28th overall. He's got 733 career points in 1,162 games. Justin Williams is a two-time 30-goal scorer. His best season was in 05-06 with 31 goals and 76 points. Danny Heatley was drafted second overall. He finished his NHL career with 791 points in 869 games. Heater was a two-time 50-goal scorer. His best season was 06-07 when he potted 50 goals and 105 points. The highest scoring player from the 2000 draft was Marian Gaborik. Gaborik was drafted third overall. He's got 815 points in 1,035 games. He's a three-time 40-goal scorer. His best year was 09-10 when he scored 42 goals and 86 points. Jason Pominville was drafted 55th overall. He's got 696 career points in 987 games. Pominville is a three-time 30-goal scorer. His best season was in 07-08 with 27 goals and 80 points. Ilya Kovalchuk was the number one overall draft in 2001. He was an exact point-a-game player during his NHL career with 816 points in 816 games. Kovalchuk was a two-time 50-goal scorer. His best year was in 05-06 with 52 goals and 98 points. The highest scoring player from the 2001 draft was the second overall pick. That's Jason Spezza. He's got 888 points in 989 games. Spezza is a five-time 30-goal scorer. His best season was in 07-08 with 34 goals and 92 points. Defenseman Duncan Keith was drafted 54th overall. He's got 543 career points in 995 games. Keith is a three-time All-Star, a two-time Norris winner, and in 09-10, Keith scored a career-high 69 points. Alex Steen was drafted 24th overall. He's got 578 points in 898 games. Steen hit a career-high 33 goals in 2013-14. His best season in terms of points was in 2014-15 with 64 points. The highest scoring player from the 2002 draft was the guy taken first overall. That was Rick Nash. Nash with 805 points in 1,060 games. He's a three-time 40-goal scorer and winner of the Rocket Richard Trophy. His best season was in 08-09 with 40 goals and 79 points. Corey Perry was drafted 28th overall. He's got 766 points in 957 games. Perry is a two-time All-Star, Rocket Richard winner, and Hart Trophy winner, too. In 2010-11, Perry scored a career-high 50 goals and 98 points. Ryan Getzlaf was drafted 19th overall. He's got 875 points in 917 games. Seven times in his 13 NHL seasons, Ryan Getzlaf has been a points-a-game player. In 08-09, Getzlaf scored a career-high 91 points. The highest-scoring player from the 2003 draft is Eric Staal. He was drafted second overall. He's got 922 points in 1,093 games. The eldest of the Staal brothers, Eric is a three-time 40-goal scorer. And in 05-06, Eric Staal scored 40 goals and had 100 points. Blake Wheeler was drafted fifth overall. He has 605 points in 778 games. Wheeler is a six-time 20-goal scorer, and this past season in 2017-18, Wheeler produced a career-high 91 points. Evgeny Malkin, taken second overall in 2004, has 930 points in just 784 games. Gino is a three-time 40-goal scorer and a three-time All-Star. Malkin scored a career-high 113 points in 08-09, winning one of his two career Art Ross Awards. The highest scoring player from the 2004 draft, no question about this, Alexander Ovechkin. OV was taken first overall, and he's got 1,122 points in just 1,003 games. Ovechkin is a seven-time 50-goal scorer, seven-time winner of the Rocket Richard Trophy, an 11-time All-Star, three-time MVP. In 07-08, Ovechkin cranked out 65 goals and 112 points to win the Art Ross. Paul Stastny, taken 44th overall, 646 career points in 824 games. Stastny is a six-time 20-goal scorer. In 09-10, he scored a career-high 79 points. Anze Kopitar was drafted 11th overall. He has 828 points in 922 games. He's a three-time 30-goal scorer and winner of the Selke Trophy in 2016. In 2017-18, Kopitar scored a career-high 92 points. Obviously, the highest scoring player from the 2005 draft was the man taken first overall. That was Sid the Kid Crosby with 1,116 points in only 864 games. Man, he's awesome. Sid with five 100-point seasons in his career. He's a seven-time All-Star, two-time MVP, two-time Art Ross winner, and two-time Rocket Richard winner. In 06-07, the 19-year-old Sid the Kid scored a career-high 120 points. Claude Giroux, drafted 22nd overall. He has 677 points in 738 career games. Giroux is a six-time 20-goal scorer. In 2017-18, Giroux scored a career-best 102 points. Phil Kessel, drafted 5th overall, has 741 points in 914 games. Phil is a six-time 30-goal scorer. In 2017-18, Kessel scored a career-high 92 points. The highest scoring player from the 06 draft was Nick Backstrom. He was the 4th overall pick, and he has 799 career points in 815 games. The Swedish Nick Backstrom is a 5-time 20-goal scorer, and in 09-10, Backstrom scored a career-high 101 points. Jakub Voracek was drafted 7th overall. He has 573 career points in 768 games. Voracek is a 5-time 20-goal scorer. This past year, in 2017-18, Voracek set a career high with 85 points. Jamie Benn was drafted 129th overall. He has 596 career points in 667 games. Benn is a 4-time 30-goal scorer and a 3-time All-Star. In 2015, he won the Art Ross, and in 2016, scored a career high 89 points. The highest scoring player from the 2007 draft was Patrick Kane. Kane was drafted number one and has 828 points in 822 games. Patty Kane is a three-time 30-goal scorer and a three-time All-Star. In 2015-16, Kane won the MVP and the Art Ross with a career-high 106 points. Jordan Eberle, taken 22nd overall. He has 441 career points in 588 games. Eberle is a six-time 20-goal scorer. He scored a career-best 76 points in 2011-12. Defenseman Erik Karlsson, drafted 15th overall. He has 518 career points in 627 games. Karlsson is a four-time All-Star and two-time winner of the Norris Trophy. In 2015-16, he scored a career-best 82 points. The highest scoring player from 2008 was Steven Stamkos. Stamkos was drafted first overall and has 668 career points in 664 games. Stammer is a two-time 50-goal scorer, two-time All-Star, two-time winner of the Rocket Richard Trophy. In 2011-12, Stamkos scored a career-high 97 points. Ryan O'Reilly, drafted 33rd overall with 422 points in 651 games. O'Reilly is a four-time 20-goal scorer, and in 2013-14, he notched a career-best 64 points. Matt Duchene, drafted third overall, with 477 points in 656 games. Duchesne is a six-time 20-goal scorer. He scored a career-best 70 points in 2013-14. The highest-scoring player from the 2009 draft was John Tavares. Tavares was drafted first overall and has 621 career points in 669 games. Tavares is a four-time 30-goal scorer, and in 2014-15, Tavares scored a career-best 86 points. Jeff Skinner, drafted 7th overall, has 379 points in 579 games. Skinner is a three-time 30-goal scorer. He won the Calder in 2011 when he scored a career-high 63 points. Taylor Hall, drafted 1st overall, he has 474 points in 529 games. Hall is a six-time 20-goal scorer. This past year, Hall cranked out a career-high 93 points. The highest-scoring player from the 2010 draft, Tyler Seguin. Seguin was drafted 2nd overall. He has 505 points in 590 career games. Seguin is a four-time 30-goal scorer. He scored a career-best 84 points in 2013-14. Ryan Nugent-Hopkins was drafted 1st overall. He has 313 points in 457 games. The Nuge is a two-time 20-goal scorer, and in both 2014 and 2015, scored a career-high 56 points. Nikita Kucherov, drafted 58th overall, has 334 career points in 365 games. Kucherov is a three-time 30-goal scorer. In 2017-18, Kucherov scored 100 points to set a new career high. The highest-scoring player from 2011 was the man drafted 2nd overall. That was Gabriel Landeskog. He has 341 career points in 506 games. Landeskog is a five-time 20-goal scorer. In 2013-14, he scored a career-best 65 points. Defenseman Morgan Riley was drafted 5th overall. He has 171 points in 388 games. The Maple Leafs defenseman set a career-high in 2017-18 with 52 points. Alex Galchenyuk was drafted 3rd overall. He has 255 points in 418 games. Galchenyuk is a two-time 20-goal scorer and in 2015-16 scored a career-high 56 points. The highest-scoring player from the 2012 draft was Philip Forsberg. Forsberg was drafted 11th overall. Now, he and Galchenyuk both have 255 career points to this point in time. However, Forsberg has done it in 87 fewer games than Galchenyuk, so I'm putting him at number one. Forsberg is a two-time 30-goal scorer, and in both 2016 and 2018, scored a career-high 64 points. Alexander Barkov, drafted 2nd overall, with 249 career points in 331 games. Barkov is a three-time 20-goal scorer. He racked up a personal best 78 points in 2017-18. Sean Monahan was drafted 6th overall. He has 281 career points in 393 games. Monahan is already a two-time 30-goal scorer. In 2017-18, Monahan set a career high with 64 points. The highest-scoring player from the 2013 draft was Nathan MacKinnon. Drafted 1st overall, MacKinnon has 303 career points in 374 career games. The 2014 Rookie of the Year is a three-time 20-goal scorer and cranked out a career-high 97 points in 2017-18. Nikolaj Ehlers, drafted 9th overall with 162 career points in 236 games. Ehlers is a two-time 20-goal scorer with a career-best 64 points in 2016-17. David Pastrnak, drafted 25th overall, has 203 points in 254 games. Pastrnak is a two-time 30-goal scorer. His 80 points in 2017-18 set a new career high. The highest-scoring player from 2014 is Leon Draisaitl. Drafted 3rd overall, he has 207 points in 269 games. He's a two-time 20-goal scorer who scored a career-high 77 points in 2016-17. Mitch Marner, drafted 4th overall, has 130 points in 159 games. The 20-year-old scored a career-high 22 goals and 69 points in 2017-18. Jack Eichel, drafted 2nd overall, has 177 points in 209 games. Eichel has three 20-goal seasons and has a career-high 64 points in 2017-18. The highest scoring player from the 2015 draft, no question, Connor McDavid. Drafted first overall with 256 career points in 209 games. McDavid has two 30-goal seasons and two 100-point seasons already to go with two Art Ross Awards. He won the MVP in 2017, set a career high with 108 points this past season in 2017-18. It's crazy that McDavid and Eichel have played the exact same number of games, but Connor has 79 more career points. Matthew Tkachuk, drafted 6th overall with 97 career points in 144 games, Tkachuk set a new career high with 24 goals and 49 points in his sophomore season. The number one overall pick, Austin Matthews, has 132 points in 144 games. The 2017 Rookie of the Year has scored 61 of his career 74 goals at even strength. The highest scoring player from 2016 is Patrick Laine. Drafted 2nd overall, has 134 points in 155 games. Laine is already averaging 40 goals a year after his first two NHL seasons. Casey Mittelstadt, drafted 8th overall, has 5 points in 6 games. Mittelstadt scored a point in 5 of his first 6 NHL games, so far the Maple Leafs are the only team to have held Mittelstadt scoreless in his career. Nolan Patrick, drafted 2nd overall, had 30 points in 73 games in his rookie season. Patrick had a nice 4-game goal scoring streak there in February of 2018. The highest scoring player from 2017 was the first overall pick, Nico Hischier. 52 points as a rookie in 82 games. Hischier had 11 multi-point games during his rookie season. I think what this list drives home is something we probably already knew, and that is having the number one overall pick is huge. I just looked at the past 18 NHL drafts, and half that time, the number one overall pick is leading that draft class in scoring. And so far, the lowest drafted player to be leading their draft class in scoring is in 2012 with Philip Forsberg, drafted 11th overall. As I mentioned in the video, tied with Alex Galchenyuk in career points at this point in time in their careers, but because Forsberg has played so many fewer games than Galchenyuk, I gave the tiebreaker to him. You could probably add Ilya Kovalchuk to that list as well. Drafted first overall, he is 2nd in his draft class in scoring, but has played 200 or more fewer games than Jason Spezza, the number 2 overall pick, who currently leads him in points. Now, if Kovalchuk comes back, I don't know if he'll be able to catch Spezza, but let's say they had played the same amount of NHL games with Kovalchuk earning a point a game during his NHL career, I think it's fairly safe to say he would be leading that draft class had he not moved over to the KHL. I think where we saw the most surprises was the 3rd highest scoring player from the draft class. We saw a lot of fairly lower picks make it into the top 3. I mean, we're talking about guys like Jason Pominville, who, yes, has had a good career at times for sure, but 3rd overall, I wouldn't have expected that when doing my research. How about Justin Williams? I mean, we think of him as a clutch playoff goal scorer, but he's also shown he can score in the regular season as well, being 3rd highest scoring player in his draft class as well. We saw a few defensemen on the list. Morgan Riley, the 3rd highest scoring player from his draft class. Duncan Keith, the 3rd highest scoring player from his draft class. These are two defensemen that are not high scoring defensemen. Seeing Erik Karlsson is still kind of a surprise. We know Karlsson is a high scoring player, but to be 2nd overall from his draft class did surprise me somewhat. Which players were you surprised to learn about being among the highest scorers from their draft classes? Do you think there will be changes in a lot of these draft class scoring rankings? Some of the more recent ones, for sure. I mean, 2017, these guys have just started. It was funny to me to see Casey Mittelstadt as the 3rd highest scoring from his draft class. The guy's only played 6 games. Shows just how little players have played from the 2017 draft class already. Some other ones, very close. Leon Draisaitl and David Pastrnak only separated by 3 or 4 points. We've got Patrick Laine and Austin Matthews only separated by a couple of points. No question that there's going to be some changes over the years in here. But what about some of the older ones? Most of the players on this list are still playing in the NHL. In fact, Danny Heatley is the only guy who comes to mind, and Ilya Kovalchuk are the only two players that come to mind that are not playing in the NHL. So do you think we'll see some changes even on the older draft classes? Please continue to like and subscribe. I'm Kurt. This is Top Corner Hockey. Thanks for watching. See you next time.